Good morning. Welcome to worship here at Salem Lutheran Church in Deerwood, Minnesota on the second Sunday in Advent, and it's also Cantata Sunday. I think you probably noticed that too. Welcome. It's good to have you here. Especially want to welcome those of you who are guests worshiping with us today. We're glad you're here. We welcome you every Cantata Sunday and every day that you would like to come and be with us. So thank you for coming and being here. Just a few announcements to highlight this morning before we get started. First of all, today is annual meeting Sunday. The annual meeting of the congregation will meet at 10:30 this morning. Agenda items include, but are not limited to, adoption of a 2020 budget, election of Salem Council and committee members, and representatives. So if you can stay and be a part of those decisions, we would love to have you for that. A reminder that scrip orders are due today. Let's see, I think there's a box in the narthex. You can put them right in there and get your order in for December. This Wednesday is the Advent luncheon. That'll be served at noon. Everybody's welcome. Come and eat. Bring a dish to pass, and we'll celebrate Advent and the coming of our Lord. This Wednesday is also the kids' intergenerational make and take. That begins at 3:15, and that's not just for the kids' club kids. That's for the whole family, so and anyone else who likes to come. So come and make some crafts, and then we're going to end it with a macaroni and cheese and hot dogs dinner, so you can't get any better than that. Today during the cantata, there will be two offerings, so just to make sure you understand that. One will be during the intermission. The place will be passed, and that'll be the regular church offering. And then there are baskets at the door as you leave. Any cantata offerings, you can place those in those baskets. The cantata this year is conducted by Kennedy Niska. Kennedy's our new choir director, and we're so happy to have him and have him working with us. And so please welcome him also as we celebrate and listen today. Are there other announcements that need to be made this morning?
Good morning. I'm going to be really brief because I know you didn't come to listen to me. I just want to remind you and tell you I'm going to talk about the baskets out on the narthex. As many of you know, your mission team is heading back to Honduras in February. This year we're going to do something different. We're going to actually be building homes. The baskets out in the narthex is our fundraiser to help us do that. While we're there, we want to be able to build two houses, and we'd like to be able to leave money for an additional two. Now, who are these people that we're building homes for? They're people that were displaced 30-some years ago by Hurricane Mitch, and they've been struggling ever since then. You've seen the pictures up on the board, up on the screens of what they are currently living in. We want to be able to help them improve their lives. What does a home look like, and what does it cost? The homes we're going to build are about the size of our bedrooms. They're about 12 by 14. What they cost is about $1,000. About $250 for the concrete floor, about $250 for the roof, and about $500 for the structure itself. You've seen what they're living in. It's pretty dismal. There's scrap wood for walls, scrap tarps for walls and roofs. The floors are dirt. Unless it's raining, then they're mud. So please consider doing whatever you can to help us. The baskets out there are on a silent auction. Next Sunday is the final day for that. There's also a cash box if you wish to write a check or put cash for the floor, the walls, the ceiling, or any amount of money that you'd like would be greatly appreciated. Thanks, Pastor.
Any other announcements? There are many other announcements in your bulletin. I invite you to read them and participate as you are able. And now, with no further ado, the ceremony of candles. I guess there's further ado. Okay. Today is the second Sunday of Advent, and we'll begin with the Advent blessing and the lighting of the Advent candles. Blessed are you, God of hope, for you promised to bring forth a shoot from the stump of Jesse, who will bring justice to the poor, who will deliver the needy and crush the oppressor, who will stand as a signal of hope for all people. As we light these candles, turn our wills to bear the fruit of repentance, Transform our hearts to live in justice and harmony with one another. And fix our eyes on the root of Jesse, Jesus Christ, the hope of all nations. And we sing the first two verses of Light One Candle, number 240 in the red hymnal.
Let there be light, and the shadows of a lowly stable felt the warmth of a new star. Let there be light, and simple shepherds woke to angel glow and brilliant beams of glory. Let there be light, and seeker kings gratefully knelt in manger dust to warm their hearts at the embers of a holy fire. The light of the world had come, and the people who walked in darkness began to see the glory of the Lord revealed in the shining eyes of a child named Jesus. Soon his light would pour from a Bethlehem cave and disperse the shadows of illness, hatred, and sin. It would burn in the hearts of faithful followers and reflect in the lives of all who looked upon his brilliant countenance. Even the darkness of death would surrender as Christ's light burst from a sealed tomb in a thousand beams of radiant light, bathing the world in glorious grace. And now, from that one perfect flame, we light our candles of hope and carry them into the shadows of our own time. With carols of faith burning in our souls, we sing the ancient star songs, we share the everlasting story, and with blazing joy, we declare to the darkness once again, let there be light. In the day of my favor, I will say to the darkness, be free. And the rising sun will come to them from heaven to guide their feet in the paths of peace. The wolf will lie down with the lamb, and a little child will lead them. Thank you.
It came to pass that the people cried out, "We look for light, but darkness surrounds us and we walk in deep shadows." When God heard their cry, he sent the prophet Isaiah with this promise, "In the day of salvation I will help you. The people walking in darkness will see a great light, and on those living in the shadows, morning will dawn. I promise to do these things, for I will not forsake you."
Those who walk in darkness, who have no light, trust in the name of the Lord. Believe, for those who place their hope in him will not be disappointed. Wait quietly. quietly for the light of his salvation. And when he comes, darkness will turn to morning and sorrow to joy.
Now it was written what the Lord would send a messenger to bear witness to the coming light. That witness was named John. Hear his voice calling, prepare the way for the Lord, for the one true light. In him is life, and that life will be a light for us all.
Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming.
As the time came for God's promise to unfold, he brought a young girl and a simple carpenter to the tiny village of Bethlehem. In the obscure backdrop of a stable, heaven and earth were joined. The circumstances surrounding this miracle would mystify the logic of many. Under the cover of night, in the silence of a sleeping town. Sorry. I was ready to go.
We continue with our regular Sunday offering.
Thank you.
Under the cover of night, in the silence of a sleeping town, the light of the world was born. No royal announcement preceded him. No throngs gathered to welcome him. In a moment of stillness, light shattered darkness without a sound. In silence he came, with grace soft as snowfall. Hushed was creation, awaiting his cry. The voice of his mother reached out in the night,
He is a glorious one.
Shepherds lived in the nearby fields, watching over their flocks. Suddenly, the skies were filled with a blinding light. They were terrified, but an angel of the Lord appeared and gave comfort to them, saying, "Be not afraid, for I have come to bring you news of great joy. Arise, for your light has come, and he shall be a savior to all people. You shall find him wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger." When the angel had left them, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem to see what has been told to us." When they found the child, they worshipped him and quickly spread the news of all they had seen and heard.
Strange new light appeared in the skies, a wondrous star causing amazement to the magi of the east. This star went ahead of them, and they followed it to Bethlehem. When it stopped over the place where the child was, they were filled with joy and fell on their knees in worship.
Thank you.
Unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given. For God, who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," has made his light shine in our hearts in the face of Christ.
No one who lights a candle puts it under a basket, but on a stand that all may see. In the same way, let your light shine so that others may see it. Once you were darkness, but now you are light. Go now in peace and live as children of light.